Welcome to the 71st lecture of Digital Electronics. In this lecture, we are going to deal with comparators. So, what is basically a comparator? Comparator means you are comparing two values. Say you are having two values A and B. So, here there are three cases. First case, when A is equal to B, then you should get an output, say output number 1. Second case, if A is less than B, you should get some other output, say output number 2. Third case, when A is greater than B, that is output number 3. So, here the main aim of a comparator is to compare between A and B. So we are having equal to concept, equal to, less than, and greater than. Okay. So we need to check these three conditions. And if the first condition is satisfied, first output will be triggered. If the second condition, that is, if A is less than B, the second condition will be triggered. And if A is greater than B, then output number 3 will be triggered. So here, in digital circuits, we have 1-bit numbers, 2-bit numbers, 4-bit numbers, 8-bit numbers, etc. Okay. So, in the scope of this lecture, we'll cover 1-bit and 2-bit comparators. Okay. So, first of all, let me come to 1-bit comparator. 1-bit comparator. So what is basically 1-bit comparator? You are comparing 1-bit numbers. Okay. Now, here there are different combinations. So, I am having two numbers, say A and B. I am having two numbers, A and B. A, B. 1-bit numbers. Okay. So, 0, this can be 0. So, this is equal to large or greater than, this is less than, this is A is equal to B, so E is equal to 1, okay. That means A and B are the inputs, E, G and L, these three are the outputs. If A is equal to B, you will get equal to output as 1, greater than and less than, output as 0. Next case, you will get 0 and 1. So here what is the condition? Here A is less than B. A is less than B. So you will get 1 here and these two are 0. Next case is 1, 0. Here what is the case? You will get A is greater than B. If A is greater than B, what will you get? You will get 1 here, 0, 0 here. Next case, the last case, 1 and 1. What is this case? Both are equal. So you will get G and L as 0. So this is the basic truth table. Okay. Now you need to find the logic expressions. You need to find the logic expressions for E, G, and L. That means E should be a function of A and B, digital function of A and B. Similarly, G should be a digital function of A and B. L again should be a digital function of A and B. Okay. Plus A and B are the inputs. Okay. Now I am going to compare. If you are drawing a black box example, it will be like this. You will get a comparator. So I am having two inputs, A and B. And for the outputs I am having equal to one output, greater than one output will be there, and less than one output will be there. So it can be so equal to will go high if A is equal to B, and greater than will go high if A is less than B. That means this is high if A is equal to B. In this case, this will be high if A is greater than B. In this case, L will be high if A is less than B. Okay. So if you are counting three LEDs at E, G and L, you will get that result. the LED will glow for these conditions. The conditions are A is equal to B, A greater than B, and A less than B. Now, let us find the condition for E. That means, what is E? E is, or we get A bar, B bar, A bar, B bar, or AB. A bar, B bar, or AB, because for these two values only, what happens? You will get E. So you can write E is equal to A bar, B bar, or AB. So what is A bar, B bar, or AB? It is basically X NOR gate. It is basically an X NOR gate. Therefore, we can write E is equal to A X NOR B. You can write it as E is equal to A X NOR B, or we can write another symbol is like this A X NOR B. Okay. So expression of E is power. Now coming to G. So what is G? G is 1 if and only if A is 1 and B is 0. Therefore we can write G is equal to A B bar. G is equal to A B bar. Now coming to the expression of L. L is 1 if and only if A is 0 and B is 1. So we can write L is equal to A bar B. So you've got three expressions. The three expressions are E is equal to A H nor B, E is equal to A H nor B, G is equal to A B bar, and L is equal to A bar B. Okay. That means for this is the condition for E. G that means A B bar. If A is 0 and B is 1, that greater than LED will get on. Again, for if A is 0 and B is 1, the less than LED will get on. Now, I need to draw a logic circuit for this. Okay, how will you draw a logic circuit for this? That is the next question, right? So, I will write E. This E. E is A X NOR B. What is G? G is A B bar. G is A B bar. And what is L is A bar B. L is A bar B. So you should have some logic circuit in which A and B are the inputs. I am having A and B are the inputs. So what is E? E is A X NOR B. So you should have an X NOR gate. This is the X NOR gate. So this is E. So what is E? E is basically A X NOR B. Now what is G? G is A B bar. So A is here and coming into B bar. B bar means you should have a NOT gate and it. So this is for G. So G is equal to A B bar. Now coming to L. L is A bar B. So you can have this is A here. So you have A bar B. So here that is L. L is equal to A bar B. Okay. So the here you get B bar. This is A bar. Okay. So that means if A is equal to B, this LED number 1, so or this E will be logic high. Again, if A is greater than B, G will be logic high. And if A is less than B, L will be logic high. So this is a basic 1-bit comparator. This is basically a 1-bit comparator based on magnitude. Okay, this is based on magnitude. Okay, this is based on magnitude comparator. So you can rename it as 1-bit magnitude comparator. Okay, hope you understood the concept of 1-bit comparator, or you can write it as 1-bit magnitude comparator. 1-bit magnitude comparator. Now coming into next one. Next one is 2-bit magnitude comparator. 2-bit magnitude comparator. So here you have two numbers having 2 bits each. So let that the number B, first number BA is A1A0. So this is LSB and this is MSB. B is B1B0. Okay. So I am having a number which is having 2 bits. A digital number which is, or a Boolean number which is having 2 bits. So again I need to check the conditions. What is the condition? Whether A is equal to B, first condition. A is greater than B, second condition. And third condition is A is less than B. So if this is the case, you will get E, this is greater than and this is less than. Okay. So you need to compare it. Now here, since there are 2 bits for these 2 numbers, you need to compare bit by bit. So coming to case 1, first case. First case is A1 is 1 and B1 is 0. If A1 is 1 and B1 is 0, obviously what happens? A1 or the A is greater than B. Okay. Because A1 is 1 and B1 is 0. What are the available combinations? A1 is 1. So you will get A can be. Okay. If A1 is 1 and B1 is 0, that is only condition what we have. So here what are the available combinations? So if this is the case, A can be 1, 0 or 1, 1. Only these two cases. Now, B can be what? 0, 1 or 0, 0. Only these two cases. So if this is the case, what happens? If you are taking the decimal equivalent, 1, 0 is 2, 1, 1 is 3. So what is it? 0, 1 is 1 and 0, 0 is 0. Obviously what happens, you can say that A is greater than B directly. Okay. So for getting G, the only condition is what? A1 should be equal to 1. A1 should be equal to 1 and B1 should be equal to 0. Therefore we can write what? G is equal to A1 B1 bar. Therefore we can write G is equal to A1 B1 bar. Now coming into second case, coming into case 2. Now coming into case 2, if A1 and B1 coincide, then what happens? Second case, A1 is equal to B1. Okay. That is second case. If A1 is equal to B1, what happens? So, what is A? What is A? A is A1, A0. And B is B1, B0. So, I am initially taking A1 is equal to 1. That means, obviously, B1 is equal to 1. So, there are two combinations. What is A? A can be 1, 0. Or 1, 1. Similarly, B also have only two combinations. What is it? 1, 0. Or 1, 1. Now again, there is another thing. B can be, if A1 is equal to 1 and B1 is equal to 1, you can make A as 1, 0 and B as 1, 1, or B as 1, 0 and A as 1, 1. That combination is there. So if A1 is equal to B1, you need to check the second bit. If A1 is equal to B1, you have to go for the second bit or LSB. Second bit or LSB. For LSB, there are two conditions. What is it? That is, here you have to check for A0 and B0. Now, in that case, again, how do you check? If A0 is greater than B0, if A0 is greater than B0, what happens? Then, which condition is there? A0 is greater than B0. That means, this is the condition. That means, here you will get 1, 1. Here you will get 1, 0. Okay. That is the only condition there. That is A0 is greater than B0. That means here what happens? Here we can say that A0 is 1 and B0 is 0. Therefore we can write A0 B0 bar. Therefore there we can write A0 B0 bar. Next case. Next case is, this is case 2A. Now coming to case 2B. case 2 B. I mean to check case 2 B. What is it? Again, A1 is B1 itself. That means there is coincidence. Now, A1 is equal to B1. Now, what is the condition? So, you have A is equal to A1, A0. And B is equal to B1, B0. A1 is equal to B1, no problem. Now, you go for the second bit. For the second bit, greater than condition is satisfied here. For the second bit, greater than condition is satisfied. That is, for A0 greater than B0, you should get A0, B0 bar. Again, one more thing. If A0 is less than B0, that means A0 should be equal to 0 and B0 should be equal to 1. Here, what is the condition? The condition is A0 bar B0. Okay, that is A0 is less than B0. Now, coming to the third condition, that is case 2C. A1 is equal to B1. I am keeping it like that. That means A is equal to A1. A1, A0. B is equal to B1, B0. 2 bits. So, here what is the condition? What I am going to give is A0 equal to B0. A0 equal to B0 means here also there is coincidence. Here also there is coincidence. Okay. So, for the second case, there are three subdivisions. Right? Okay. Now, next case. Coming to the case 3. Case 3. The third case is A1 is equal to 0 and B1 is equal to 1. A1 is equal to 0 and B1 is equal to 1. Right? Obviously, here what happens? If A1 is equal to 0 and B1 is equal to 1, obviously what happens? You will get A is less than B. You will get A is less than B. So, here L LED should go. And in this case, the G LED should go. Okay. So, here what is the condition? For L, you can write it as A1 bar B1. For L LED, that means less than LED to glow, you can write L is equal to A1 bar B1. Now, how to deal with the case 2? How to deal with the case 2? That is the next question. Okay. For case 2, the condition which is required is A1 is equal to B1. Right? Okay, A1 is equal to B1 condition should be there. Along with that you should have what? You should have the other conditions. Right? Okay. So, coming into that. Yeah. Coming to the case 2 separately. In case 2. What is there? Coming to the case 2 condition separately. So, I am having A1 is equal to B1. That is the condition I am having. Okay. So, along with that, you should satisfy the other conditions. Okay. That is, if A1 is equal... Okay. One second. Yeah. Okay. Now, let's start from here. If A1 is equal to B1, then you need to select for the lower bit. So, in that case, if A0 is greater than B0, obviously here you can say that A is greater than B. If A0 is greater than B0, obviously you can say that A is greater than B. So, how do you account for that? That means, here what you have to do is, you need to account for A1 is coinciding with B1. A1 is coinciding with B1. Provided this A0 and B0 bar is valid. Okay. Again, that means for greater than condition you got what? A1 is equal to B1 along with this one. Right? Okay. So you can write G as A1 coinciding with B1. So, here you cannot, to get the coincidence, you can use XNOR gate. So, A1, B1, XNOR. But, along with what? Along with A0, B0 bar. Along with B0 bar. Again, to get the greater than condition, you should have what? This one also. A1, B1 bar. So, you can have or A1, B1 bar. Okay, hope you understood. Okay, so for greater than condition, there are two factors influencing that. That means A1 is equal to 1 and B1 is equal to 0. Obviously, you can write A is greater than B. One more case is there, when there is coincidence, that is when A1 is equal to B1, you have to look for A0 and B0. In that, if A0 and A0 is greater than B0, obviously you can say that A is greater than B. Therefore, you will get A0 B0 bar. But A0 B0 bar is valid only if there is a coincidence. Okay. So, how do you check the coincidence? Coincidence can be checked by using XNOR gate. So, you can write G is equal to A1 XNOR B1. Dot A1 XNOR B1 dot A0 B0 bar. That is with condition. And one more condition, or we can go with A1 B1 bar. So you got the expression for G. So G is equal to A1 XNOR B1 and A0 B0 bar or A1 B1 bar. So that is for greater than condition. Now coming into less than condition. For less than condition, there should be coincidence. But along with the coincidence, you should have what? A0 bar B0. And again, for this less than condition, one more thing is applicable. What is it? A1 bar B1. Therefore, we can write that the expression for L is equal to, first you write, this is obvious, that is A1 bar B1. If that case is satisfied, you will get a lower condition. Or, next case is, there should be coincidence, that is A1 XNOR B1 and A0 bar B0. Okay. So you got the expressions, right? So you can write three things here. So I'm just rubbing this off. Okay. So we are having 2-bit magnitude comparator. We are having 2-bit magnitude comparator. Okay. So the numbers you need to compare are A is equal to A1 A0 and B is equal to B1 B0. Now for equal to condition. For equal to condition, what you need to satisfy? For equal to condition, what you need to satisfy? That is, here you will get less than. So equal to condition is not being dealt here, right? Okay. So for equal to condition, what is the condition? You need to make A1 is equal to B1 and A0 is equal to B0. That means for equal to condition, you should have A1 XNOR B1 and what? A0 XNOR B0. Okay. So that is for equal to condition. That is the first condition. This should be satisfied. Now coming to second condition. This is for equal to. That means A is equal to B. Second case is A greater than B. In A greater than B, you have two conditions. What is it? G is equal to. Here we have, what is G? For A greater than B, you should have A1 B1 bar and coincidence along with A0 B0 bar. That is G is equal to A1 B1 bar along with what? Along with the coincidence. Coincidence, that is A1 XNOR B1. A1 XNOR B1. Along with A0 B0 bar. Along with A0 B0 bar. That is for greater than condition. Now, third condition is for A less than B. What is that for A less than B? If this is for equal to, this is for A greater than B. That is, here A is equal to B. This is A is equal to B condition. This is A greater than B condition. And this is A less than B condition. This is A greater than B means L will be closed. G will be growing. Here you will get F. So, what is L? So, L you can write directly. Either you should get LS and B. That means A1 bar B1. Should get A1 bar B1. Or there is a coincidence, that is A1 XNOR B1 of first bit, that along with what? That along with A0, that along with what? A0 bar B0. A0 bar B0. So you got the three expressions, equal to option, greater than option, and less than option. Now create a circuit for it. Okay. So I'll write the expressions separately. For equal to, you should have A1 XNOR B1 and A0 XNOR B0. For greater than condition, what should we get satisfied? A1 B1 bar should get A1 B1 bar, or if there is a coincidence, A1 XNOR B1, then you should go with A0. Good, A0 B0 bar. A0 B0 bar. Again, if it is the same condition, you should go with A1 bar B, A1 bar B1, or along with the coincidence, that is A1 X0 B1, you should go with A0 bar B0. So you need to draw the circuit for it. Okay. So I am having A, B, and C as A1. B1, A0, B0 as inputs. A1, A0, B1, B0 as inputs. So here you have A1, XNOR, B1. A1, XNOR, B1. Means A1 is there, B1 is there. A1, XNOR, B1. And A0 XNOR B2. A0 XNOR B2. And these two should be ANDed. Okay. Here you will get E. Next one is A1 B1 bar. So A1 is there. This one. A1 B1 bar, this is B1, A1, B1 bar, we give an AND gate, A1, B1 bar, or A1 XNOR B, A1 XNOR B1, okay, that is here, yeah, A1 XNOR B1, so this is A1 XNOR B1, A1 XNOR B1, and A0 B0 bar, A0 is there. A0 is there, and this is B0 bar. So you are ANDing it. So you will get, here what you get is A0 B0 bar. This is A0 B0 bar, and with the coincidence condition, and with the coincidence condition, and you OR these two. Should OR these two. So you will get, here you will get greater than condition. Now coming into less than condition, first one is A1 bar B1. Right? So we'll draw with other color. So you will get A1, yeah, this is A1. I will take something from here. Wait. Okay. So I will take another input as A1 bar, no problem. So you get A1 bar B1. A1 bar B1 is there. A1 bar B1. Then along with this combination, A0 bar B0. So you get A0 bar and B0, I am taking it here. A0 bar B0, then A0 bar B0, and this should be ANDed here. This should be ANDed here. And here what you get? You will get A1 bar B1. So these two things should be OR. these two things should be odd. Okay. So here you will get plus sign. Okay. So this is the basic logic circuit of a 2-bit magnitude comparator. Okay. So to explain this 2-bit magnitude comparator, once more coming in, for 2-bit magnitude comparator, we have what? We have A is equal, you have 2 bits, A is equal to A1 A0 and B is equal to B1 B0. So, first case, A1 is equal to 1 and B1 is equal to 0. Obviously, what happens, A1 will be greater than, A will be greater than B. So, for greater, you will get A1 B1 bar. That is the first condition. Now, in second condition, if you need to get equal to, you can, that means A1 can be equal to B1. If A1 is equal to B1, you should have an equality check. That equality check is using which gate, XNOR gate. So if A1 is equal to B1, then again you have to check for A greater than B or A less than B. That means if A0 is greater than B0, you will get A is greater than B. So in that case, A0, B0 bar. Okay. So that is the first case. That is, A greater than B is true for two conditions. First condition is A1 B1 bar, and second condition is A1 S0, that means A1 coincides with B1, but that along with A0 B0 bar, you will get greater than condition. Now coming into next case, that is for the coincidence, that means A1 is equal to B1, so you will get coincidence, and if A0 is less than B0, obviously what will you get? Obviously you will get that A is less than B. So you will get A0, A0 bar, B0. Third case is, if A1 is equal to B1, if A1 is equal to B1, you will get, and A0 is equal to B0, then you will get it is coincidence. Okay, that means if A1 is equal to B1 and A0 is equal to B0, you should have coincidence. That means, you should have A1 XNOR B1 and A0 XNOR B0. And if that result is 1, you will get it as a coincidence. Okay. Now, third case is, if A1 is equal to 0 and B1 is equal to 1, obviously you can say that A is less than B. But what is the condition for that? A1 bar B1. So, here which condition should be satisfied? To be less than condition, coincidence along with the A0 bar B0 or directly A1 bar B1. If any of these two conditions are satisfied, then you will get less than condition. So, that less than expression is written here. Now for the equality, I have already mentioned that A1 is equal to B1 and A0 should be equal to B0. Therefore for equality, you have A1 XNOR B1 and A0 XNOR B0. That is for equality. Now for A greater than B, what is the condition? It should be A1 B1 bar. It can be A1 B1 bar or coincidence along with A0 B0 bar. Coincidence along with A0 B0 bar, similarly you will get less than condition. They have formulated a circuit, a 2-bit magnitude comparator circuit. Okay. And I think you have got a concept of 1-bit magnitude comparator and a 2-bit magnitude comparator. In the next lecture, we will be dealing with 4-bit magnitude comparator, and with that, we will end with the portions of comparator. Thank you.